around 200 people. It is not only the people who are sitting on the dais, they can give you something. It is a peer group, you know, which can provide solutions to your problems. It is a peer group when you share with them, you know, maybe they are facing the same problem and something has worked with them, and maybe that you can try and that can work with you. So NEPA provides, you know, 10, 16 days of a capacity building program. And then we have now started the online program, the details for which will be provided by Dr. Kripi during her session as to how we can enroll for the our online program. And now we have, you know, almost, you know, 34,000 school heads have already enrolled in them. And rest of the, I would request the rest of you, you know, who have not enrolled, to kindly go through. This is the basic one. And then we are going to also have the, you know, middle level and the advanced level courses also for the school leadership. So then you, maybe, you know, when we are talking about, as I said, what is the, I am really fascinated to see this leading schools and leading learning. You know, when you have to lead the schools, you have to have some of the, you know, skills which are required. And that is that problem solving and taking initiative according to your circumstances, according to your local context, then only you will be able to lead school. And if you want to lead learning, my request would be, my humble request would be that all the school heads and all teachers, we are the continuous learner irrespective of age. Unless we update our knowledge, unless we update our skills.
I have been in this field last more than 30 years. But in the management of the school, you'd be surprised, I was working in bank for 30 years. And after that, I came in this field.
The staff members serving at this center, we warmly welcome you. And I hope this today's conference will be a very successful and a fruitful one. That is my wish and my prayer for you. Most of you are here for the first time. That is at least what I am given to understand. And many of you early morning when you came here, they were saying, Father, what a lovely place, nice place. We thank you for all that. Something about this place belongs to the Archdiocese of Goa in Daman. It is under the Bishop of Goa. This place, the building that you see on the other side, some of you must have noticed that, it was built in the early 17th century. Because on this hill, they say, Jesus appeared on a cross.
Grief and unhappiness. Flame symbolizes wisdom and knowledge. A lamp teaches you to be upright, rise upwards, and dispel darkness.
We had it on the heads of headmasters. A beautiful event taking place. An event like this, where a lot of intellectuals participate, it cannot be arranged by one person, and within a day it requires meticulous planning and bird's eye for details. We are fortunate enough to be backed by a team very motivated and dedicated colleagues.
I was told that he couldn't make it today. He discusses the business of the house with the offices in the morning. I am sorry about that. On behalf of CM's office, I will convey this. I am deeply honored here to be part of this program, of which is organized by all the intellectual minds. The participants also are intellectual minds who are having a very good academic background with the association with Samagra Shiksha. Just to solve the problems which they might be facing day to day, and also increasing in the capacity building. In-service training actually adds to different things. It adds to the knowledge. Although it may be any age that training is imparted, it adds to the knowledge and capacity building of the concerned participants. It not only focuses on the innovative ideas, but there are certain decisions which we take in the past. But once training is attended by the participant, there is entire different focus which is achieved, and a person starts thinking in a different way.